Yeah, let me put this question across to you, Ram. Lots of people are tweeting now saying, look, when you have your processions that nobody dare pass some places in Zaria, and then there's another comment that's asking you that there was also another incident, and he says this happened around Gilisua with the former Governor Yero, who was also not allowed to pass when you were having your processions. Is that the case?
It's not the case. Whenever we are having our own procession, we have a guard corps we call Hurras. They try to ensure safe passage to the other commuters, and also they try to make sure that there is no unnecessary commotion on the street. And in fact, this has been the case. That is why, even though we normally have procession, especially after the detention of the Sheikh, almost on a weekly basis, there has not been any confrontation with the authorities. We are always peaceful. Even if you ask the Igbo traders along the streets we normally pass, they will tell you they fear nothing from us. We don't attack anybody. We don't abuse anybody. We just pass with our children, with our women.
You're peaceful, but nobody else passes the road.
No. They do pass. If you look at other clips, we have many clips. And if we normally stop people from passing, it wouldn't have been like this. The movement has been in existence for the past 40 years.
Just wondering though, why didn't you go and put this position out in the judicial panel?
As I told you earlier on, the judicial commission was set up to be biased against us. There are three people in the commission we vehemently objected to their being in the commission because of their writings, speeches, and the rest of them. And we believe they must have input in the commission. And also, there is the absence of the international bodies.
You've given these reasons, but you know, people will still say. I mean, one of the first reasons you gave was that you know your leader wasn't there to put out the version of the sect.
Yes.
But you know, if you are able to present your side before the public on the media, on media platforms, why don't you think that you know the Judicial Commission will at least be able to take in the comments that you've taken now?
No. Before we do that, the Judicial Commission should have the moral and legal justification to do what it's assigned to do.
So your biggest problem was the composition of the panel?
The composition and the incarceration of our leader. We will have prepared an independent Judicial Commission with the international human rights bodies present as witnesses or even members of the commission. There we will table our grievances. Look, the National Human Rights Commission invited us. We were there. We presented our papers to them, telling them what happened, simply because we believe we will get fairness there because of the composition and because of the impartiality in the whole thing. But Brother Kaduna is different.
Nyota has a question for you.
When you went to the National Human Rights Commission, assuming they came up with a recommendation that you were wrong, would you stand by it?
If they said we are wrong, if it is true we are wrong, we'll agree.
No, but if they said you were wrong, would you accept it?
There is anything that they will claim that we are doing unlawful or is against other international laws or something like that.
So your laws, the laws you stand by, and must be international, not the local laws. Is that what you're saying?
No, you have to obey the local law before even the international law comes in.
Okay.
Tell me, we want any of our detractors to tell us what we have done that is contrary to the Nigerian law. Any property we destroyed? Have we killed anybody?
Let me even understand something before we wrap up. Just a minute, if you can hear me. Let's understand what you're thinking is. Are you then saying that, yes, we've heard you say that there was fracas before the Chief of Army Staff arrived, but having arrived as the Chief of Army Staff and having seen the convoy with all the paraphernalia that they came with, couldn't the group, or were you saying that he should have diverted and not the group making way for him, fracas or not?
You know, in a conflict situation, you cannot determine what will happen. People were aggrieved. Before the arrival of the chief of army staff, it was confirmed to us 5 people were gunned down by the soldiers at the gate. So you can imagine how furious people were at that time. But what I believe is the chief of army staff should have known from an intelligence report that something bad happened at that particular place, which means he shouldn't have come into that disaster area in the first place.
All right, Mr. Ibrahim Musa, we have to thank you for coming on the program today. Ibrahim Musa is the spokesperson for Islamic movements in Nigeria, but also the president of the Media Forum of the group. We'll be back in a moment. Join us again.